Welcome all. Today we are going to look into the another part of surface chemistry, that how the chemical reaction takes place on the surface and how this catalyst and the catalytic process helps them to do so. Catalyst is a substance that speeds up a chemical reaction, but it is not consumed by the reaction. Hence, a catalyst can be recovered chemically unchanged at the end of the reaction. It has been used to speed up or catalyze. Here you can see the graph given, that is the energy diagram, by using catalyst and in the absence of catalyst how the reaction is taking place. Here you can see the two graph is been plotted, that is one with the purple color and another with the green color. Red purple color is the graph conversion of reactant to product without catalyst. Whereas when we are adding catalyst into the given chemical reaction, at that moment you can see how catalyst speed up the reaction, and within less period of time we obtained our deserved required product. So activation energy you can see with no catalyst present, that is quite high. You need to give lots of activation energy, whereas with the presence of catalyst the activation energy is less. There are some industrial catalytic process that takes place in the presence of catalyst. For example, Haber's process for the manufacture of ammonia. And Mindwell, you can see the different chemical reactions are taking place in the presence of different catalysts. Right, the same catalyst cannot be utilized for the various particular chemical reactions. They have certain limitations as well. Okay, so here we have the different examples, that is Haber's process for the manufacture of ammonia. It is giving, that is N2 gas plus 3 H2 gas gives 2 ammonia, right, in the presence of iron as a catalyst and molybdenum as a promoter. Promoter helps in helps the reaction to take place faster. Then Ostwald process is for the manufacturing of nitric acid. These are the steps involved in the Ostwald process. Here we are using the platinized asbestos at different temperatures, such as 573 Kelvin. Now this temperature, pressure and catalyst is very important conditions that you need to take care to obtain the required product. Next, the contact process for the manufacture of sulfuric acid. Right, first of all oleum is produced and then we convert the oleum into the sulfuric acid. Right, by doing so it becomes little bit, the reaction is very exothermic. So here we can lower down the temperature by producing oleum first. Then what is the catalyst over used here? Either platinized asbestos or vanadium pentoxide is used over here, and the temperature maintained. Next, as I told you about what are promoters. So the substance that enhance the activity of a catalyst, is known as promoters. Example, molybdenum acts as a promoter in the Haber's process. Next, even catalyst can be a poison as well, some substance, right? Poisons are the substance which decrease the activity of a catalyst. Example, arsenic acts as catalytic poison in the manufacturing of sulfuric acid by contact process. So you need to be very careful that arsenic related impurities should also be not present under when this process is undergoing or taking place, right? So the substance which decrease the activity of a catalyst, they are known as poisons. The substance that increase the activity of the catalyst, they are known as promoters. Now, what is activity? The capacity of a catalyst to increase the speed of the chemical reaction is known as the activity. I repeat, the capacity of a catalyst to increase the speed of the chemical reaction is known as the activity. Whereas, it is the, for example, you can see here the water molecule, the formation of water molecule in presence of your platinum as in catalyst. So, here what happens, the activity of a catalyst totally depends upon the strength of the chemisorption to a large extent. The reactants must get adsorbed reasonably strongly onto the catalyst to become active. However, they must not get adsorbed so strongly that they are immobilized. Immobilized matlab wo move nahi kar paate. And other reactions are left with no space on the catalyst surface, for catalytic activity increases from group 5 to group 11 metals, with maximum activity being shown by group 7 to 9 elements of the periodic table. So you can check here that these are the elements which increases the activity. Now when we talk about selectivity, okay, the selectivity of a catalyst is its ability to direct a reaction to yield a particular product. Right, तो हमें बहुत ही selective होना जरूरी है कि ये particular catalyst, ये particular product ही बनाएगा. In the given example, you can see, right, the reactant are same, but by changing the catalyst, the product is different. So here you can see, to obtain the desired product, we need to be selective with the catalyst, though the reactant is same. Okay, so we have here the example, that is carbon monoxide and H2 react to form different products in presence of different catalyst, right? So you can see how important the catalyst is, how important the selection of catalyst is. Now, catalysis can be broadly divided into the two groups, right? We have the basically two groups, that is homogeneous catalysis and heterogeneous catalysis. Now, what is catalysis? So, substance which accelerate the rate of chemical reaction and themselves remain chemically and quantitatively unchanged after the reaction are known as catalyst, and the phenomenon is known as catalysis. I repeat, the in a given chemical reaction, the catalyst is used. That particular chemical reaction is known as catalysis. We have different, basically two different types of catalysis, that is homogeneous catalysis and heterogeneous catalysis. Then we will also be seeing shape selective catalysis and enzyme catalysis. So what is a homogeneous catalysis? The homogeneous catalysis, homogeneous, homo means same. So homogeneous catalysis defines, that is, if the reactant and the catalyst are in the same phase, then that type of catalysis process is known as homogeneous catalysis. That is, when the reactant and the catalyst are in the same phase, that is, either it may be liquid or gas, the process is said to be homogeneous catalysis. We have few examples placed over here, that is via the oxidation of sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide in presence of nitrogen oxide as an catalyst. Okay, next is hydrolysis of methyl acetate is catalyzed by H plus ions furnished by hydrochloric acid. So we are able to obtain the acetic acid and alcohol. Next is hydrolysis of sugar is catalyzed again by H plus ion, but here it is furnished by sulfuric acid. Now why the acids are different, right? Here you can see the solutions with water. We know that sulfuric acid is the acid with high concentration. It can act as a dehydrating agent. Next is your heterogeneous catalysis, the process in which the reactant and the catalyst are in different phases. Hence, here you can see the examples are given below, where you can see the reactant is in gaseous phase, whereas your catalyst is in solid state. So again, these few examples have been noted down, that is oxidation of sulfur dioxide into sulfur trioxide, where you have the gas, I mean sulfur dioxide is in gaseous phase, whereas your catalyst is in solid phase. Similarly, by introduction of Haber's process, that is introduction of ammonia by Haber's process, we are obtaining ammonia gas in presence of N2 gas and H2 gas with the help of the iron catalyst, which is solid in state. Next is your oxidation of ammonia to nitric oxide in the presence of platinum gauze, which is all given by the Ostwald process, right? Then hydrogenation of vegetable oil in the presence of finely divided nickel as a catalyst. We are able to convert vegetable oil into vegetable ghee. Heat selective catalysis. The catalytic reaction that depends upon the pore structure of the catalyst and the size of the reactant and product molecules, they are known as shape selective catalysis. Where example you can take, that is of zeolite, right, which is having a honeycomb like structure. Zeolites are the good shaped selective catalyst because of their honeycomb like structures. They are microporous aluminosilicates. Mind well, what are zeolites? Zeolites are aluminosilicates. Aluminosilicates with three-dimensional network of silicates in which some silicon atoms are replaced by aluminium atoms, giving Al bond O bond Si framework. The reaction taking place in zeolites depends upon the size and shape of reactant and product molecules, as well as upon the pores and cavities of the zeolite. They are found in nature as well as synthesized for catalytic selectivity. Zeolites are being widely used as catalysts in petrochemical industries for cracking of hydrocarbon and isomerization. An important zeolite catalyst used in the petroleum industry, which is named as ZSM5. It converts alcohols directly into gasoline, that is petrol, by dehydrating them to give a mixture of hydrocarbons. Hence, zeolites are the aluminosilicates. This has been asked number of times, that what are zeolites chemically. So zeolites are aluminosilicates. Next comes your enzyme catalyst. Enzymes are complex nitrogenous organic compounds which are produced by living plants and animals. Now, enzymes, we can simply call it as a biochemical catalyst. Enzymes are present even inside our body as well. That is the reason why we say enzymes are complex nitrogenous organic compounds which are produced by living plants and animals. They are actually protein molecules of high molecular mass and form colloidal solutions in water. They are very effective catalysts. They are very effective catalysts. Catalyze numerous reactions, especially those connected with natural processes. Numerous reactions that occur in the bodies of animals and plants to maintain the life process are catalyzed by enzymes. The enzymes are thus termed as biochemical catalysts, and the phenomenon is known as biochemical catalysis. Many enzymes have been obtained in pure crystalline state from living cells. However, the first enzyme that was synthesized in the laboratory in 1969. We are going to check few enzymatic reactions. The enzymatic reactions that takes place in our day-to-day life is, that is, conversion of sucrose to glucose and fructose. In the presence of enzyme known as invertase, then glucose and fructose, glucose then converted into the ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide with the help of the zymase. Similarly, when the starch is converted into maltose, diesterase enzyme is used. Maltose converted into glucose, right? What are the starch, maltose? What are these? They are coming under the carbohydrates that we will be learning in the biomolecules. Then conversion of urea to ammonia and carbon dioxide, that is in presence of urease. Now can you see that each of the enzyme named is ASE, which is been prepared, right? Which has been produced. These all are named as ASE. Now how they have been given name, you can see with respect to either the reactant or the product. Here you can see glucose and fructose are the product while converting sucrose, right? So glucose and fructose are known as invert sugar because glucose is an aldehyde whereas fructose is a ketone. Hence from invert sugar it has been named as invertase. Similarly, here as well, the alcohol, the Zea, right? So from that, it has been named as zymase. Maltose, right? It is disaccharide salt. I mean disaccharide sugar. That is why it is known as diesterase. Here, maltose is converting into glucose. So with respect to the reactant, the enzyme is given name. Similarly, here urea is the reactant to obtain ammonia and carbon dioxide, hence the enzyme name given is urease. Now this is, that is, biochemical process which is taking place in our body while converting protein into the amino acids. It is. Now, characteristics of enzyme catalysis. The characteristics of enzyme catalysis, they are given as follows. Enzyme catalysis is unique in its efficiency and high degree of specificity. Therefore, the enzyme catalysis are highly specific nature. This you can prove by taking an example, that is, one catalyst cannot catalyze more than one reaction. For example, the enzyme urease catalyzes the hydrolysis of urea only. It does not catalyze hydrolysis of any other amide. Hence, the enzyme catalysis is highly specific in nature. They are most highly efficient because one molecule of an enzyme may transform 1,000,000 molecules of the reactant per minute. They are highly active under the optimum temperature. Optimum temperature means a maximum, when it becomes maximum at a definite temperature. That is, the rate of an enzyme reaction becomes maximum at a definite temperature, which is called as the optimum temperature. I repeat, what is optimum temperature? The rate of an enzyme reactions becomes maximum at a definite temperature called the optimum temperature. On either side of the optimum temperature, the enzyme activity decreases. The optimum temperature range for enzymatic activity is 298 to 310 Kelvin. Human body temperature being 310 Kelvin is suited for enzyme catalyzed reactions. Therefore, in our body, the enzymatic enzymatic reactions are taking place for the digestion of food and other process as well. Then increasing, highly active under optimum pH. Okay, the pH is to be maintained, the pH is to be maintained, the rate of an enzyme catalyst reaction is maximum at a particular pH called optimum pH, which is between pH values 5 to 7. Increasing activity in presence of activators and coenzymes, the enzymatic activity is increased in the presence of certain substances which is known as coenzymes. I repeat, the enzymatic activity is increased in the presence of certain substances known as coenzymes. It has been observed that when a small non-protein, that is vitamin, is present along with an enzyme, the catalytic activity is enhanced considerably. Activators are generally metal ions such as sodium ion, Mn2 ion, CO2+, Cu2+, etc. Amylase in presence of sodium chloride, that is sodium ions, are catalytically very active. Then how it has been influenced in the presence of inhibitors and poisons? Like ordinary catalysts, enzymes are also inhibited or poisoned by the presence of certain substance. The inhibitors or poisons interact with the active functional groups on the enzyme surface and often reduce or completely destroy the catalytic activity of the enzymes. The use of many drugs is related to their action as enzyme inhibitors in the body. Now we are going to quickly check how this mechanism takes place. Mechanism of enzyme catalysis. You can see here on your left hand side of your slide that how the mechanism takes place. Here we have an enzyme which is having a shape. Through that particular shape, the substrate can enter into it and it get fixed into it. Now the place where the substrate can attach, that site is known as an active site. I repeat, the place where the substrate can get attached, that place is known as the active sites. So there are number of cavities present on the surface of colloidal particles of enzymes. These cavities are of characteristic shape and possess active groups such as amino group, carboxylic acid group, thio group, that is SH, and OH group, and many more. These are actually the active centers on the surface of enzyme particles. The molecules of the reactant, that is the substrate, which have complete complementary shape, fit into these cavities just like a key fits into a lock. On account of the presence of the active groups, an activated complex is formed, which then decomposes to yield the product. This mechanism, you can see it on the right hand side where I have placed the lock and key mechanism. Right, you have an enzyme. We have a substrate with respect to the particular enzymes that we have. Right, so here we have the two active centers where the substrate will get fixed and it forms enzyme substrate complex. Then afterwards, when it is forming a product, it releases out, right, that is ES complex again separates into the product. ES is separated into E plus P. You can check here, this blue part is your E, whereas sky blue and yellow part is your product. I hope you have understood this. Now we have, so what are the two steps involved in the mechanism of enzyme catalysis? That is, first is binding of enzyme to the substrate to form an activated complex, and second step is decomposition of the activated complex to form product. So first is binding and second is decomposition. Hope you have understood these terms clearly and the difference between the catalyst and the enzymes. Okay, so please go through this video one more time. Stay healthy, stay fine. Good day.